Hello everyone, welcome to the Assorted Bag. So today we are going to look at a very interesting topic. We're going to look at the tips and strategies that can help you enhance your English speaking ability. So there are these few strategies that most of the people who are able to learn this language quickly follow. So every English learner might make use of the learning process in a different manner. The learning process might vary for everybody, but there are a few common things that if you practice on a daily basis or regularly can actually help you achieve a good hold on this language, and will be able to, you know, speak this language fluently within a very short period of time. So let's get into today's video and see what are these tips and strategies that can help you speak fluent English very quickly. The first tip that I'm going to share here, every grammar expert might not be very fond of it, but yes, we need to accept the fact that English language can be strange or weird at times. Say for instance, the word READ is also, you know, we call it read as well as read, depending on whether we are talking about the present tense or the past tense. So things like this was a very simple example. So where there are very, you know, these kind of strange or weird exceptions in English language. So there are certain English language rules that are very good and straightforward, but there could be these exceptions or, you know, strange words that you actually cannot come out with a logical reasoning. So if you, you know, run behind finding a reason for each of them, they might actually have a reason, but if you are running behind finding the reason for it, you will be deviating from the goal of learning English speaking fluently. So for these kind of exceptions, I would suggest let's memorize it and just let it be that way and just move on. So that is actually tip number one. If once you're fluent with your English language, you can very well go and ahead and research on why these words or expressions are strange in English. But if your goal is to speak English fluently, let's focus on that and let's accept these exceptions and move on. So the next tip deals with the distinction between failure and success. So when you're learning a language, rather than being a student of it, think that you already know it to a certain extent. So instead of saying that you are learning English or thinking that you are learning English, consider yourself to be one who is already speaking English. So instead of saying that I learn English, say I speak English. This is actually going to make you believe in yourself, make you feel more confident. You know, you'll get that introvert feeling out of you and you can more confidently speak in this language, which will do nothing but enhance the language in the long run. So the next tip deals with answering questions, you know, in English language. So what happens when somebody asks you a question and you're not sure of how to reply in English? Well, you need to always know that sometimes, or you can say most of the time, your answer will be in the question. See, for example, if somebody's question begins with, does he do something? And your answer will be something like, yes, he does. Or if there is a question like, can you do something? And your answer will be like, yes, I can. So you see, the words that you use in your answer are actually coming from the question. These were very simple examples, but then you can actually implement it for longer or complex questions as well. So when you have to answer a question, always know that most of the words that you need to use in your answer will actually be there in the question. So once you hear the question properly, frame the answer in your mind, making use of words in the question, and you'll be good to go and answer the question in English. When you're learning a language, the key is to find a balance between learning and speaking. So when you're talking about being able to speak English fluently, you're going to focus on how well you communicate using English language and not specifically on the grammar. So being perfect in speaking English is different than being a perfect English grammar expert. So when you are trying to, you know, become fluent in this language, do not focus on getting your grammar right. Fluency is about being able to communicate properly. There are certain aspects of grammar that can be left out when you're learning a language, especially when you're learning spoken English. These aspects can be left out because it's only going to complicate stuff. And most of the time when you're speaking fluently, you'll get the idea right to communicate with whomever it is. So there's no point in actually getting all of your grammar errors fixed at this point. So focus on speaking rather than fixing your grammar. The next tip is a very important one. It's about not being afraid of making mistakes. So when you're communicating in English, don't worry about making grammatical errors. Even a native English speaker might make, you know, errors in terms of grammar or mess up a sentence in terms of English language rules. So it's okay if you make mistakes. As long as you're framing a simple English language sentence, it's fine. Holding yourself back and restraining yourself from, you know, communicating because the communication is taking place in English is only going to make you lose confidence. So irrespective of, you know, how well you know the language, attempt. Try making and framing a sentence in English. And as long as you're fluent and, you know, able to make a decent sentence, your motive or whatever you're trying to communicate will go across to the listener. So don't refrain yourself. Don't limit yourself when speaking English. Don't be afraid of making mistakes because we all learn from mistakes. So it's fine to make a few grammatical errors when you're communicating, especially when you're communicating among friends or in a casual atmosphere. Tip is listening. So when you're among a bunch of people who are communicating in English, listen to what they're trying to say or how they're framing their sentences. So this will enable you to catch new phrases, new expressions, new ideas, new words, which you can, you know, incorporate when you are framing sentences. So listening is a very good technique to enhance your English speaking ability. And another thing which might sound funny to you but is a good habit is speaking in front of the mirror. So if you lack confidence or you're not sure of how well you're speaking English, stand in front of the mirror, frame few sentences and speak out. Speak out as loud as you can because that's only going to build your confidence and you will be amazed at the way you're able to frame sentences beautifully in simple English. The last tip and the ultimate tip is practice, practice and more practice. So listen things in English, watch things in English, read things in English, and that's only going to help you, you know, go forward in your English language fluent speaking journey faster and quickly and help you achieve your goal in a very short span of time. So I shall end the video here today. Don't forget to hit the thumbs up if you found today's video informative and do leave in the comment section which particular tip you follow to enhance your English speaking abilities. And I shall see you all soon again. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell icon, and thank you for watching today's video. I shall see you all soon. Take care. Thank you for watching and bye-bye.